I'm Tracy Baxter with today's Record News Watch. He had faced felony charges involving a scheme to rig the process so that the friend of a village trustee could get hired as a Monticello police officer. Today, former Monticello village manager John LaGreci pleaded guilty to three misdemeanor official misconduct charges. LaGreci's plea in Sullivan County Court today came in exchange for his testimony against village trustee T.C. Hutchins and Monticello resident Kareem McCline, the man who Hutchins wanted to hire. Felony charges of coercion and falsifying business records against LaGreci were dismissed. When he's sentenced, LaGreci is expected to get 3 years probation and no jail time. Hutchins still faces trial on charges of felony coercion and official misconduct. Meantime, it's more fuel for the fire in Monticello, as Mayor Gordon Jenkins has sent off a letter claiming members of the village's fire department use the N-word and have shown a lack of respect towards African Americans. The letter grew out of a confrontation over jurisdiction at an accident scene that involved the mayor, fire officials, and the village code enforcement officer. In his letter, Jenkins said, quote, "Something has to be done about these recurring incidents," end quote. Monticello Village Trustee Carmen Rue called the mayor's racism claim nonsense. A Monticello woman was ordered held without bail in Sullivan County Jail following her arrest for sexually assaulting a child. 44-year-old Tina Vivenzio was charged following a state police investigation into reports she had sexual contact with a child. Police say the investigation revealed that Vivenzio sexually assaulted a child less than 13 years old repeatedly over a two-year period. She was charged with predatory sexual assault against a child and endangering the welfare of a child. In the wake of the latest Albany corruption case comes word of more than 100,000 campaign finance violations involving New York State lawmakers. The documented violations, part of a report compiled by NYPIRG, the New York Public Interest Research Group. It says almost 104,000 violations have occurred since 2011, including questionable use of campaign donations, failure to file accurate reports, or any reports at all. Governor Andrew Cuomo's proposed legislation to increase enforcement of election law by creating the position of election czar. They huddled under a small tent, but this morning's drenching rain wasn't about to stop a group of women from taking part in the ceremonial Habitat for Humanity groundbreaking, marking the start of construction of the fifth women-built house, this one in Newburgh's revived East Parmenter Street neighborhood. This is Habitat International's National Women Build Week, and the Newburgh chapter is celebrating not only with the groundbreaking for the new house, but with women volunteers continuing work on another Habitat house across the street. Longtime Habitat volunteer Celeste Bloomer says it's all about inspiring women to become involved in their communities.
There's an understanding of a need for safe housing for children, for our families, and we see that. We build for a family. We make a house a home. We may not know every aspect of construction, but we know every aspect of raising a family and what it means. We have a family among ourselves, and we're here for each other in every aspect, from things that are happening in our personal lives to learning how to cook together or to spackle. And as I've said, when you do have troubles, when you need to heal from something, volunteer. It's the best thing you can do is to pull outside of yourself and to help other people.
When I walk people down to show them what we're doing in this community, I will be able to talk about how important women are to our work and the value and the community that they bring to it.
Women Builds are houses built with at least 80% women construction volunteers. The newest house should be completed by the summer of 2014. More than 20 Habitat homes have gone up on East Parmenter, a formerly blighted neighborhood that continues to undergo a renaissance. And it may be getting warmer out there, but Courtney Green has been thinking about colder conditions and specifically the bobsled. Courtney recently moved to Walden from Birmingham, Alabama to train with Rick Scarpula at the Ultimate Advantage Training Center in Bloomingburg. Green is currently doing alternate training there before she hits the bobsled course in Lake Placid later this fall. Courtney's hoping to make the U.S. Olympic bobsled team in 2014 and 2018. Find out more about her training and her Olympic dreams in an upcoming edition of the Times Herald Record. We could get a little more rain in the days ahead after today's drenching May showers. Thursday will be mostly cloudy with a chance of a passing shower or two. The highs will be up around 70 degrees. Friday's weather will feature a mix of sun and clouds, with a late day shower a possibility. Temperatures Friday will reach the middle 70s. Stay informed by starting your day with the Times Herald Record, and stay on top of breaking news throughout the day right here at Record Online. For Record News Watch, I'm Tracy Banks.